report on everything that happened this morning, Agilon legal analyst and criminal defense attorney Joey Jackson joins us now on the story. Two of the things that really stood out for me, what we learned from Gene in court this morning. Number one, the defense leaving the jury with, this man's liberty is now in your hands. Powerful ending there. And also the fact that we've now learned that there were tapes of this phone call that happened between Andrea Constand's mother and Bill Cosby, and we will hear them in court. And that call is significant because it was made just after, as the timeline goes, Andrea Constand told her mother what happened.
Huge, right? So let's talk about a trial and what it's about and the drama. You have two professors in the courtroom, and each has a separate narrative. And the narrative of the prosecution is trust, a violation of that trust. Betrayal. He betrayed her. She trusted him. And what's more, she didn't consent at all. And you have the defense saying, nonsense. They had such a relationship. This was predicated upon consent. And there's only one thing worse than sexually assaulting someone, and that's lying about it. So you have these two narratives that come together. Now, to your point, where the defense leads off by saying, you have his liberty in your hands. That lets the jury know the gravity of the moment. We want you to pay attention. But then let's transform to what you then talked about, which were those tapes. Now, here's why they're critical. Because after the fact, this was after this alleged assault, now Ms. Constand is back home with her mom, and her mom is noticing things that are just not right. Your behavior's a little different. Your appetite's a little different. Who you were is just a little different. We know how you were, but that's not you. What's wrong? What's the matter? And so she calls Bill Cosby, and we're not going to have to apparently rely upon what she says happened.
We're going to hear it.
Go to the tapes, right? And we'll hear exactly what occurred. And in the event that on those tapes are promises of, you know what, I'll take care of her education, everything will be good, come meet me in Florida, we'll go to the hotel, we'll talk about all of this. And yes, I gave her a few things. These are all admissions, and they're also, Erica, consciousness of guilt. If I did nothing to you, right, and it was all consensual, why am I offering to pay your tuition? That's the prosecution will argue.
Right.
Why am I saying meet me at a hotel, we'll sort it out? So that could potentially be very damaging.
Well, we should point out, too, we've been told that in that conversation, Bill Cosby confirmed to the mother exactly what that inappropriate contact was. So
absolutely.
Those details are in there, too. We only have about 30 seconds left. How powerful, how impactful, I should say, was it to have someone like Keisha Knight Pulliam, not Camille Cosby, walking into court today with Bill Cosby?
You know, ultimately, jurors are told, whatever you see, disregard, unless it's on the witness stand. So we don't care who's in the audience, we don't care anything else, they're instructed, it goes to the witness stand. But, to your point, we're people, and we want people who are standing up next to him. She believes in him, she trusts him, and you know what, she's putting her credibility behind him by standing with him. And that, Erica, regardless of what the judge says, has to have an effect.
And it's tough not to remember Rudy Huxtable. And all, I mean that very seriously.
Yes. The battle has begun.
And we will continue to watch it. You and me here from the sidelines.
Look forward to it.
Joey Jackson, thank you, my friend.